stitch the pieces in place before you attempt to put the velvet on, because velvet has this kind of twist very easily. So you want this to be held in place and make it easy for yourself as much as possible. I have already put the velvet on the one side, so it's the top one that I'm doing at the moment. Before I attempt to put the velvet on, I'm just cutting it down with quite a big stitching. Now, second time around, I'm going to be sewing just a little bit above that existing stitching, and just a couple of things to bear in mind when you do sew with velvet is press it into place first. It does tend to curl up. And to stop it, so fold it in double and sew about half an inch above the seam that you've already done, because we want this to turn over just over into the right place. Make sure that there's no pull in the velvet in the stitching, and because the foot will I'm going to just slightly loosen the foot up, so it does tend to drag along with the foot, so you constantly need to keep easing it so that it keeps it doesn't drag along. What happens is if you let it go at its own pace, the material on the top would stretch and be wider than the material at the bottom, and you will end up having a big twist, a pull in the fabric. So as I was saying, just sew this about half an inch above the existing seam with a lot of ease, lifting the foot occasionally just to ease the fabric, because it's velvet and it's a stretchy type of velvet, and it does tend to drag with the foot and also curl up. So since we don't want it to curl up and we don't want it to drag with the foot, we have to use extra caution. Now you do need a touch of patience and patience and a little bit of dedication for this. So don't get carried away and don't get panicky and lose your patience while doing this, because if anything is going to ruin this, the look of this, then it is haste. Don't want to hastily do this. We want to use a little bit of now while you're doing this, what may happen is you may feel like the fabric is slightly pulling, and what you can do, if you can see, I've got a pin here, and I am just pushing the fabric into place with the aid of a pin, just to stop it from dragging along. And it's almost like a crease effect when you do this, but that crease effect goes out with the iron, and it stops the fabric from dragging along and then bulging up, which forms sort of like a massive crease which you can't iron out. And so that's a very easy way of easing the fabric underneath the foot, just pushing it slightly towards the foot while sewing on top of it. It just assists you to not let the fabric, stretchy fabric, drag along. And that just, it doesn't apply to velvet, it applies to lots of other fabrics as well. And that, once pressed into place, should sit nicely. So I'm going to press this into place before I proceed any further. I've placed the iron marks to do the darts. Now my darts are going to start at the where I've placed the this sort of on the bust point where. Where I've trimmed it off. So starting at that point, I'm going to at a distance of approximately 7.5 inches, and that is going to give it a more of a fitted look. I'll just zoom out a little bit so you can see what it is that I've done. So that's the neckline, as you can see, and that is the darts that I've placed in, and then that is the hemline. So I've used the brown from the silhouette of the designer suit. And then I've used the velvet to trim these off, and in between I've used the turquoise piece. And if I'm giving a true verdict, it looks quite astonishing and amazing. So that's the front of my dress complete. Now there is only one slight glitch here. The velvet tends to stretch, so as you can see, the linen is exactly the same, but the velvet has, when I've ironed it, it has stretched out, even though I cut these exactly the same. So I'm just going to trim that down so that it stops me later on from when I attach the sleeves, that I end up missing out on. Now if you want, what you can do is, if I did the velvet sleeves, they would have looked equally nice. So you can opt out of doing the sleeves in the linen. Instead of doing them in the linen, you can do them in the velvet. But I have actually cut them out in the linen, so I will do them in the linen. But that is the dramatic effect of the leftover pieces of the designer suit. Now the rest of this is quite simple. I'm going to attach it on the shoulders for the back, add on the sleeves, and then I'm going to trim the sleeves off in exactly the same as what I've done here on the border of the camise. I have got pieces left over, so I'm not going to bother videoing all this, and I will give you the final result. Now I think what I'm going to do with this is, I'm going to go for a velvet scarf in this. So I'm going to cut a velvet scarf, and then I've got plenty of the turquoise material left over, and I may just trim off the edges with that turquoise, and hopefully I will show you the finished result.